I'm Anil Mall with the Canadian Securities Exchange, and I'm here today in California with Steve White, CEO of Harvest Health and Recreation. Steve, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Why don't we begin by you telling us a little bit about Harvest Health and Recreation and what you guys are doing in the cannabis space?
Sure. We're a multi-state operator, vertically integrated. We have licenses for over 70 retail dispensaries and more than 15 cultivations and more than 15 processing facilities across the United States.
Now, what about some of the milestones that are coming up that you can maybe talk a little bit about?
So for us, milestones include a lot of M&A that's in the pipeline, and that's one of the points in going public, was to have that stock to use as a currency so that we can make acquisitions more regularly and more quickly. As far as milestones industry-wide, the biggest milestone that you're going to see in the near future is the passage of the States Act. And with the passage of the States Act, what you're going to see is a lot of U.S. institutional capital start to really pour into U.S. cannabis. And you will see a rise in the stock prices of those U.S. operators.
For people that might not know what the State Act is, are you able to maybe just give us
Sure.
a couple of pointers on that?
So the States Act is a piece of legislation contemplated at the federal level. And what it effectively does is it says, if a state chooses to regulate cannabis, then it is legal federally. And so presently right now, if a state has cannabis regulations, it's legal in the state, but illegal federally.
Got it.
So it effectively pushes the option to regulate down to the states and allows the states to regulate those markets.